Welcome to Best of Friends, where it really pays to share.
Hi, Ebs. Is that my hat?
Yeah. But I thought, you know, because we're mates, you wouldn't...
No.
You wouldn't mind.
It's my hat.
Well, you can wear mine.
Okay. Oh.
Put it on.
Great.
As I was saying, Best of Friends, it really...
Are those my trainers?
Yeah, they're cool, so I thought I could borrow them for a little...
Oh, you got it all wrong. Where are your trainers?
You can wear mine, dude.
Oh, great. They're horrible. Yeah. Who's on today's show?
Oh, let me just get the script.
Are those my pants?
Yeah, but don't worry, dude. Share alike. Let me get mine for you.
No, don't worry about it. It's fine.
Lewis is my best mate because he's funny but stupid, but he's always there for you.
I like Leah because she's nice, helpful, kind, and she cheers you up.
Dean is my best friend because she's helpful and funny.
Alysha's my best friend because I've known her a long time.
I like Steph because she's really kind and helpful and she's always there for you.
Hi guys, welcome to Best of Friends.
Hi!
So Steph, how well do you know each other?
I know them all really well, but I know Alysha the best. And there's not a lot of stuff that we don't know about each other.
Yes, I've heard you know each other very well, because I've also heard that Dean has dated all three girls in the group. Is this true?
Yeah, but it was all at different times, and when he went out with me, he was primary one.
Oh, it was ages ago.
Yeah.
Everybody has a nickname, but there's one really weird nickname that one of you has. Alysha, your nickname is Lou. Now, I can't see how you get from Alysha to Lou. So I'm going to ask Leah, why is she named after a toilet?
It's not because she's named after a toilet, it's just because she's small.
Oh, so Lou means small?
Yeah.
So, Lewis, if four of you could go and do the final treat together, who would miss out?
Me, because they're all my best friends and I wouldn't let them miss out, so I'd do it.
Would you guys let him do that?
Yeah.
You would?
Now, there's been a small addition to this series, so if you hear this noise... It means that we're going to bring in a surprise element to the show that will really test your friendship.
Right then, should we get things started? First of all then, we need to do the unlucky dip.
In here are five sweets, three of which will turn your tongue blue. If that happens to you, it's a task. You suck!
Who's got the blue tongue? That means that you three girls will be doing the first task and you two boys will be enjoying the first treat.
But will it be Abs or myself who'll be joining you? Unlucky dip!
I'm going to let you go first.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
What do we do now?
You suck!
Time to find out what colour those tongues are. Here we go. One, two, three. Not having much luck at this, are you? Never mind. So, girls, you'll be with Otis for the first task. Boys, you'll be with me for the first treat. But before we do that, let's have our first circle of friendship. In we get. One, two, three.
Football friends, football man. We're the best friends you've ever had. Woo! Yeah.
Seeing as I am the taskmaster, it's only fitting that your first task be with me. Are you ready to find out what it is?
Yeah.
Feeling nervous?
Yeah.
Great. Here we go. Task one, the welly bean relay. Beans, good for your heart, but not so good for your feet. See this Wellington boot? Well, we're going to fill it with beans and then you must compete in our welly bean relay. All three of you must, one at a time, collect two slices of toast and return to the start wearing our giant baked bean-filled wellies in under a minute and 30 seconds, or you fail. fail. I don't know what you're complaining about. You all like sports, right? You're very sporty girls.
Yeah.
It's just running.
Beans.
Yeah, but beans. What do you reckon? Reckon it's something you could do?
No.
I'll ask that again.
Do you reckon it's something you could do?
No.
Okay, fair enough. Let's go.
So you're looking forward to this first treat?
Yeah.
Let's find out what it is. Okay. Treat one. You're off to bounce and soar like a performer in the circus on a trapeze trampoline.
Oh.
You'll have the trampoline all to yourselves where you can jump, somersault and backflip for as long as you want.
Oh, yes.
Sound good?
Yeah.
Should we flip out?
Yeah.
Come on then.
The Welly Bean Relay is your first task, ladies. All you have to do is run up to that flag there. There is a toast rack with 6 slices of toast. Bring 2 pieces of toast each back and then place them in the rack. That's all you have to do, and you've got 1 minute and 30 seconds in which to do it. So speed is of the essence. Okay? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Oh, no, you're not. You've got to put on your welly bean boots first. So, Alysha, you first. Put your feet in. Go on, all the way. Oh, how does that feel? Come on, don't be shy, it's only food.
We have to do
this. Mmm!
Come
on! It's a full in.
No!
Oh, yes! So come on, lean back a little bit for me and let's top up the beans. Top up the boots with the beans, my friend.
The best part was when I managed to do a front flip because I've been trying for ages and I just didn't get it.
On your marks, get set, go! No! Don't fall over! Get back up! Come on, you can do it!
When I first put my feet in the Wellington boots, it felt really squidgy and disgusting.
Grab 2 pieces, now leg it back, come on! You've got to go really fast! Get yourself a good little rhythm. There it is, Leah, go! Go! Quickly!
Walking in a Wellington boot full of beans felt soggy and heavy.
You should have done that all the way up. 2 pieces in. Stephanie, leg it! Just confess your girl admits that we the shit.
Next time I think I'm going to volunteer for the task because they've already like done a task, so I want to do it.
Come on!
Because it was last, I thought I was going to fail because I only had 15 seconds left and I was only at the yellow flag.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, yes! You've passed, well done! Welcome back, everyone.
Hi.
How was your treat, Lewis?
We got a muckabout on a trapeze.
A trapeze? What's a trapeze?
It's like a trampoline, but you get stopped in.
No way. So, like, you can do flips and stuff?
Yeah.
Excellent. What was the most fun part of that?
I managed to do a backflip, front flip, and then a backflip, but then I landed on my face.
So then, Alysha, what was the task?
Well, we had to put on Wellington boots with covered in beans. In beans in it. And then Otis tipped them even more in.
Otis? Well, why would you be so mean?
The beans help to, like, lubricate the joints like oil does. In cogs and stuff, and it made them go faster.
So did you have a time limit on it, did you say?
Yeah.
How long?
1 minute and 30 seconds.
1 minute and 30 seconds. Okay, we need to know, did you pass or did you fail?
Yeah, baby.
Cracking start.
And so what that means, basically, is you only need 2 people to go through to do the task in the next round. Now, two of you can volunteer, or you can allow the chosen two to be chosen by our choosing unlucky dip.
Do you want to have a chat about it?
Yeah.
Go on then.
Right, me and Dean will do it.
Seems like a pretty straightforward chat there. Who wants to tell us what you're going to do?
Well,
I will. Pick me. Alysha, what are you going to do?
Dean and Wes have got to do it. They've volunteered.
Right. One of us will be joining you guys. It's unlucky dip time. Eyes closed.
They're closed.
Whatever.
Okay, I've got a sweep.
I've got a sweep. What do we do now?
You suck!
Three, two, one. And that's how it should be.
Circle of friendship.
Yes.
Yeah, come on, let's go.
Football friends, football mag, we're the best friend you ever had.
Yeah! Are you ready for the second task then?
Yeah.
You know it's going to get a little bit tougher?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Task two. Scottish oatcakes are a local favourite, especially when they're dipped into a nice cup of tea. Which is a shame for you, because you'll be dipping your oatcakes into our mystery substances. Then you'll have to identify these by taste alone. In order to pass, you must get 5 out of 6 correct.
5 out of 6?
5 out of 6.
That looks hard.
That is hard.
So let's go and find out what your 6 items are.
Okay, it's treat time, and that's only fair because you guys did the task last time round. Excited?
Yeah.
Okay, let's find out what we've got in store for you. You are going to be testing your shooting skills at a paintball range. Take aim and see who will be the sharpest shooter. Anyone been paintballing before?
No.
Does this sound cool or what?
Yeah.
Let's go!
All right, guys, you've got 6 ingredients in front of you here, and we've got your 6 oatmeal cakes as well, which we're going to dip into those ingredients and taste. You excited?
No.
I didn't think so. Okay, you have to get at least 5 correct, okay? If you get more than 1 wrong, you will fail this task. I don't mean to put too much pressure on you, but you're ready to go?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll start this end. If you both just come with me this way, just nice and slowly, I'll get the biscuits ready for you. Okay, you're now in front of the first item. I'll break up this biscuit. There's your hand there, hold on to it. There you go, I'm gonna dip it in for you. There you go, that's for you. You can start tasting that. You guys need to confirm what you think it is.
That's tomato ketchup.
I knew it was tomato ketchup because I love tomato ketchup. And when I was younger, I used to make tomato ketchup sandwiches.
When you hold it, you're going to be pointing down the range at all times.
Okay, treat soldiers. Ready, aim, fire!
The best bit of the treat was shooting the targets and seeing it with the paintball splatting all over the target.
Whoa!
My dog caught.
You know. Okay.
Where is it? God.
No, I've just licked it. I think it's prawns.
Oh, it's definitely nothing fishy.
Fish.
You think so?
I think it's no. I think it's some kind of sauce, maybe.
You don't want any more prawns?
No.
Okay.
No way.
Mm. I hate prawns. Okay. Prawns. This one's for you, Lewis.
I was letting Dean do all his decisions because he was a lot better at the task than me.
Peas.
Final answer?
Peas.
Peas. Here you go, Lewis, where's your hand? Before this one breaks up. Here you go, shove that in your mouth. Can you get some flavour from that?
Mm-hmm. I think it's vinegar.
Soup, vinegar, maybe combine the two.
A vinegar soup.
A vinegar soup, that's good.
I don't know how the boys are doing on their task, but I think they're really strong, so I hope they work together.
Two more items to go then. Whoa. Okay, we'll go first for you there, Dean. You got that one? Again, quite liquidy, this one.
a tomato soup.
It's gonna be tomato.
It tastes like tomato soup.
Oh, it's not.
But get a double taste. It tastes like tomato soup.
Oh, should I put tomato soup just to be safe?
Yeah, just to be safe.
Tomato soup. Okay. Almost there. Doing well so far, chaps.
Okay, this one's a liquidy one.
Yeah, it's another liquidy one, but it's kind of like a lighter liquid. There you go. And it's for you.
Brown sauce. I hate brown sauce.
Brown sauce.
It's brown sauce.
So, final answer.
Brown sauce.
Brown sauce. Are you ready to see how you've done?
Yeah.
Okay, then, here we go. First one you said was ketchup. The answer was ketchup.
Yes.
So, one from one. Next, you said this one was prawns. I couldn't help you out. It wasn't prawns, it was rice pudding. All right? So that's one that's wrong. We're only allowed to make one mistake. This one, peas. Look at it in there, grim. Peas, mushy peas. All right? This one,
we've got this one.
Liquidy. You said soup. It's close. It was gravy. Okay? Because you nailed the other ones as well. You said tomato soup on that one. It was tomato soup. This one, brown sauce, was brown sauce. But I'm afraid this is the one that caught you out with the prawns. It was gravy. What an eventful day, hey, with the girls putting those Wellington boots on, all the baked beans flooding out, and then the boys having to dip those oatmeal cakes into the mushy peas, the gravy. Otis, what are you doing?
What?
Don't do that. That's got soup in there and gravy and rice pudding.
I thought something wasn't right. Needs ketchup. Hey!
Dude, the girls rule.
You think so?
Yep.
I mean, they passed their first task, which is great. The boys, I know, were a little bit worried after their second task yesterday.
They failed it.
Disappointing for them.
The girls will be telling them what to do next.
You think so?
Yes.
The boys are quite keen to have an unlucky dip.
I don't think that's going to happen.
Really?
Yeah.
Let's go and find out.
Welcome back.
Hi.
Now, what did you get up to for your second treat yesterday?
We went footballing.
Paintballing, wow, was that good fun?
Yeah.
Lewis, tell us about your task yesterday.
We had our update, we had to dip it in various things like tomato ketchup, brown sauce and all that.
Why were you dipping oatcakes into tomato sauce and stuff?
We had to taste it and we were blindfolded and we had to try and guess what it was.
I see. Was it difficult?
It was really difficult, because some we knew, because we normally have them, like tomato ketchup and that.
Yeah.
But there was some, like, rice pudding that we never had before.
You've never had rice pudding before? So what did it taste like?
Prawns.
That's some really bad rice pudding. The question is, fellas, did you pass or did you fail?
We failed.
Oh, no!
That means that we still need two of you to go on and do the final task, which isn't great news.
Two of you can volunteer, or you can use the unlucky dip to select two of you. Does anybody know what that means?
It's a surprise twist.
And I can tell you exactly what it is. Here we go. Best of friends, in a moment, you'll be passed an envelope. In the envelope are five pieces of paper. You must take one each. Only one piece of paper has the word leader on it. The person who becomes leader will have to, on their own, choose who does the final task. Okay, do you understand?
Yeah.
That means no conferring, no secret sign languaging, and no telepathy. Five pieces of paper.
Leah, you first.
Up.
It's not you.
Stephanie. It's not you. Lou. It's not you. Which means it'll be one of the two. Let's. Oh, hold it up so we can all see it. Lewis, it looks like it's you, just to prove that there is only one. Hold it up. There we are.
So, Lewis, it's going to be your choice who goes on the final task. You're going to have 10 seconds to decide what you want to do, and your time starts now. Time, Lewis. we need to find out what you've decided to do. So is it going to be two of you or a group of you? If it's two of you, I need to know those names, please.
It's going to be two, and I'm going to pick the strongest.
And who, in your opinion, are the strongest members of the team?
I'd say Dean and Steph.
Dean and Steph. So is that your final answer for this final task? You'd like to put Dean and Steph through? Dean, are you happy with that?
I feel nervous because, like, if we don't do it, we won't get to do the final treat, and it's the hardest task.
Exactly right. And Steph?
Well, if we don't pass that, I feel like the teammates are just going to get a little bit sad.
I'm sure they won't. I'm sure they'll be very supportive. Am I right, guys?
Yeah.
There you go.
OK, which of us will be going with you? That is the question. Let's bring in the unlucky dip.
It might be you, or it might be me. You're going first, though. OK, we've got our sweets. What do we do now?
You suck!
One, two, three...
It's Otis. So you three off to do the final task. Two girls and Lewis, we will be enjoying the final treat for sure. But before we do that, let's form our final circle of friendship.
Football fans, football man, we're the best friends you've ever had!
Yeah!
OK, the final task is about to be upon you. Lewis has obviously chosen you because he's got a lot of faith in you. What kind of task do you think he's hoping for you?
Sport one.
Sport, yeah? You're both very athletic. OK, well, so shall we find out what it is?
Yeah.
OK. Highland Games. We're in Scotland, so how about taking part in our very own Best of Friends Highland Games? There'll be haggis hurling and caber tossing. As a team, with one throw in each event, you need to exceed the distance marked. One of you must reach this distance in each event in order for you to both pass. If you don't fling them far enough, you will fail. How's that sound? Hard. You can both run, you can both jump and do all those kind of sporting things, but can you throw? You can throw, but you're still a bit worried about it. Yeah? Let's just get it over and done with, shall we? Let's hit the task.
Are you ready for your final treat?
Yeah.
Okay, you're gonna have to help me summon the envelope. Are you ready? Yummy, 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 yummy. Yummy, 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 yummy.
Wow!
That's amazing. Let's find out what your final treat is. For your final treat, you will be DJs for a day. You're going to a radio station to record your own radio show. How does that sound?
Yes.
Have you got your DJ voices ready? Okay then, let's record a show, Poptastic.
Highland Games, a very difficult final task. In order to pass, at least one of you, with one throw in each event, has to get your haggis and your caber, in this instance, a marrow or courgette, past the marked distance. Okay, so with your haggis, you've got to get beyond 15 metres, marked up by the yellow flags. And with your cabers, you have to get beyond 9 metres, which is marked by the red flags. Okay, that's all you have to do. But they're quite big distances, all right? Now, we're not just going to throw you in the deep end and let you have a go. You're going to get to practice first, like any top athlete would. So, pick an item and get chucking. See how far you can chuck that. Okay. Okay, your turn. Give it a good throw. That was pretty good. Give it a throw. Very nice. Very nice. Very heavy, isn't it?
Hi, Vicky. How are you doing? I'm Abs.
Hi, Abs. Nice to meet you. Welcome to North Sound One.
Thanks, mate.
What we're going to do is we're going to take you through to the studio so you can see what happens when we're live on air. And then after you've spoken to one of the DJs, we'll take you through to our Studio 3, where you're all going to get the chance to be a DJ and make your own radio show.
Sound good?
Yeah.
Before we get started, here are some goodies for you. Mm-hmm. One for each of you. There we go.
Brilliant.
Should we get started?
Let's do it.
Excellent. Follow me then.
Okay.
Well, that's the end of your practice run. Your haggises don't look like they're going to cause you any problems at all. But with your caber tossing, I think you need a bit of improvement. but there's no more time for any practice, so you've just got to concentrate, be confident, and do your thing, all right? Let's do it.
After the practice throws, I felt like I was going to get over the line.
Right. Stephanie, you'll be game first, okay? And we'll be throwing haggises first, all right? Away you go.
Steph had her shot and she missed. It piled the pressure on me and I got just a little too much pressure.
Stephanie, I'm afraid you didn't make the distance there, so it's all on you. Dean, time to hurl your haggis. Good luck. Take your time. Think about your technique, okay? Think about how you want to do it before you throw. Well, I'm afraid you didn't make the distance either, and because neither of you passed the first event, you failed the task. Abs.
Hi, Otis.
I'm ringing from the task.
Yeah, they both failed, I'm afraid.
Shocker. All right, well, it's a pretty cool treat what we're enjoying at the moment. I have to go and break those guys, they're going to be disappointed.
Uh-huh.
All right, mate, speak to you soon. Bye. Hi, guys. Sorry to disturb your treat. How are you doing?
Fine.
Okay, well, I've got some news about the final task. It's not good news, I'm afraid. We're not going to be joined by the others because they failed that final task. So it's going to be just the four of us. Should we try and have a little bit of fun anyway?
Yeah.
All right, come with me.
I think me and Stephanie should be allowed to go on to the treat because we've worked really hard on all of our tasks.
My name's Alysha and I go to Bramble Green.
I was really upset when we found out that Steph and Dean had failed, but we just tried to have as much fun as we could.
I'm searching for something beyond my understanding, looking for meaning where nothing is demanding.
The thing I've learned about my friends is that we have fun whatever we're doing.
I think that we'll all be best of friends for a really long time.
I think Steph's worked the hardest in the group because she had to do two tasks and they were both really disgusting.
I know now Dean is my best friend in the whole world.
I think we'll be best friends for a long time because we knew each other and I think that we're a strong team.
Thanks very much for tuning in to another edition of Best of Friends. Unfortunately, this friendship not quite making the distance. Who knows what will happen next time, though, when we'll be putting more friendships to the test.